this opportunity to come where you are and for us to join together as believers. Amen. To call on the name of the Lord. Yeah, I have a subject. Lord, give me something to say to the people to encourage you or to warn you. Amen. Hallelujah. I believe in preaching what God say. Amen. Sometimes it's nice. Sometimes it's not so nice. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. But we need to hear it. Amen. God is not a God to tell you everything you want to hear. Amen. But he is a God to tell you everything you need to hear. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Take heed. Amen. That's another good word. Take heed to what the Lord say to his people. Amen. He warns us because he loves us. I done told you, you know your parents, I done told you not to go on that refrigerator and mess with them cookies. Amen. And when so you come back, there's 12 cookies in there. There better be 12 when I come back here. Hallelujah. You come back, she come back home, and that 12 cookies ain't in there. It's going to be some 12 minutes of pain, 12 years of slave. You understand what I'm saying? There going to be some problems now. Hallelujah. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So God warns us to let us know, amen, the right way to do things. Amen. Hallelujah. And if we continue in wrongdoing, judgment comes. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. But he never judged anybody. Y'all tell me, y'all preachers, y'all that know the scriptures, y'all tell me what judgment came without a warning. Amen. Y'all talk to me. Amen. Well, type to me. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What judgment came, y'all? That's a good homework for y'all. What judgment came to anyone that was not warned? Hallelujah. Amen. Ahead of time. Amen. That did not know through the scriptures, did not know the law. Amen. What they were supposed to do. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So God gives us warning. He gives us due warnings. Amen. Before the judgment comes. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So, and judgment will begin at the house. We read that yesterday, I believe, a little day before this week. Amen. Judgment shall begin at the house of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. That's why. Because it's supposed to be the house of God. It's supposed to represent God. Amen. So today is a different subject. Today is a word of encouragement. The Lord gave this to me last night. Amen. Hallelujah. As good as gold. Amen. Hallelujah. As good as gold. Amen. Amen. And gold is a precious commodity. As y'all go to Job 23:10. Amen. Amen. As y'all go to Job 23:10. We know that it's precious commodity. It's defined, amen, hallelujah, as a yellow precious metal, a chemical element of atomic number 79, used especially in jewelry, decoration, amen, hallelujah. And it guarantees the value of currency, amen, the gold standard, amen. It's supposed to represent that dollar bill. It's supposed to represent $1 worth of gold, because everybody was walking around with gold in their pockets and everything and exchanging and paying for things with gold, amen. And so a better way would have a gold note, a dollar note represents a dollar's worth of gold. It was supposed to, amen, in the coin, amen. So, and that's what, and they held the gold in Fort Knox and other places and to represent, amen, gold. Amen. And so they're still there. I think, I don't know, I've never been in there. Hallelujah. Amen. But they say it's there. Amen. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. And it's different. It's strong. Gold is gold no matter what. Amen. As they go through the process of purifying, amen, the gold and cleaning it up. Amen. Hallelujah. And getting all the impurities out of it. I was watching the videos and the different subjects on gold. I was all in gold today. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. And so the refineries and how they melted down smelting and get this what's called slag out of it. Amen. And then they poured and refined it even more. Amen. To get it even more pure. Amen. It was strange to see how much they burned the gold, but the gold didn't change into anything else but gold. Amen. But the other additives that they put in it to bring out the gold, Lord Jesus, that's a word right there. Hallelujah. Amen. Preaching already. Amen. Hallelujah. To bring the gold out. Amen. And so the other stuff can't take the same heat as gold. That's why they got to fire it up. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. To bring the gold out of it. Amen. They dig way down. All gold ain't on the top of the ground. Amen. Y'all see these shows. There's a lot of TV shows. Amen. A gold rush. Rush, and amen. I used to watch that a lot, amen. And Yukon Gold, a lot of these shows where they go digging for gold and everything on top of the ground. They go deep into the earth, and they break it up and break up the rocks and amen and the layers and break and chunk it up and they break it down the rocks and grind it down to gravel and grind it down to like a sand, amen. They grind it even that down to like a water liquid. Amen. Hallelujah. And then separate, add some additives to that. Amen. And then the additives hold on to the gold. And then they take the additives and the gold that's held to each other. Amen. And then put that in a pot and cook it. Hallelujah. They boil it. Amen. Hallelujah. In a kiln. Amen. Until, amen, the gold melts and the other product melts. But when it cools off, the other product can't stick to the gold anymore with heat. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm trying to help somebody today. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So it was the process of what it is, of getting out what's in there. Amen. Even though it's still the same chemical element. Amen. Even in the dirt. Amen. But the gold bar is just the refinery. Amen. The fashioning. Amen. And creating it to become, amen, pure gold. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. But it was gold in the dirt. Oh, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. I hope you get this. I might be already done. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. If you got that right there, that's it right there. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. So let's read the scripture. Job going through, amen, trials and tribulation. Amen. Because Satan came to God and said, amen. Hallelujah. I'm coming to and fro seeking whom I may devour. And God said, well, have you considered my servant Job, faithful and upright man, shunneth the evil fear of God? Amen. Have you tried him? Amen. God, Satan says, God, you got too much around him. He got too much stuff. Amen. He got too many things in his life. He too gifted. Gave me too many gifts and talented. Amen. Able to do, amen, great things. Amen. Hallelujah. So, but if you let me take his stuff, his things, I'll make him curse you to your face. Amen. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. And so, amen. God said, go ahead, but you don't touch his life. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Isn't it good to know that, amen, what you have around you, your products, your goods and services, amen, is not your life. Hallelujah. God said, amen, do what you want with his stuff, amen, but don't take his life. Hallelujah. Everybody think your life is what you have. Hallelujah. Amen. God, thank you. Hallelujah. But what I have is greater than, amen, who I am is greater than what I have. Hallelujah. Thank you. Down on the inside of me, amen, if I just had a car, if I just had the right job, if I just had the right man, if I just had the right woman, if I just lived in a better place. Hallelujah. Amen. The things around you are not you. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You are greater than the sum of your parts. Lord Jesus, help me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So Satan said, give me that stuff. Hallelujah. And I'll make him cuss you out. That's what he meant when he said it. I'll make him curse you to your face. Amen. Hallelujah. I think that's the same thing. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Go ahead, but don't touch his life. Hallelujah. Amen. What shall I render unto God for all his benefits toward me? I'll take the cup of salvation and I'll call upon the name of the Lord. What you saying, preacher? There's nothing, a thing around you that is greater than what God has created in you. Amen. Hallelujah. But it has to be refined. Hallelujah. It has to come out. You have to go through the process, my brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. For the gold to come out. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You might be in the dirt. Amen. Might not seem like, amen, life is valuable. It might not seem like you are valuable. Amen. Hallelujah. But you got to go through the rigor. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You got to go through the processing. Amen. The refinery. Amen. To bring out the gold in you. Where is it? Amen. Where is it? Amen. Is it at church? Hallelujah. Thank you. Is it at your job? Hallelujah. Is it in your community? Pastor, you ain't read the scripture yet. Amen. Y'all give me a minute. Hallelujah. Amen. Is it in your children? Is it in your wife and your husband? Amen. Is it in your last name? The pedigree. Hallelujah. Your family line. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Where is your gold today? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Where is it? Where is it? Where is it? Hallelujah. Or are you it? Hallelujah. Made in his image. Oh, God. Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Made in his image and in his likeness. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Created. Amen. By the creator. Hallelujah. You're created by the creator. 24 karat, baby. Hallelujah. He created you 24 karat. Hallelujah. He made you pure. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He made you pure. Hallelujah. Breathe into man the breath of life, and man became a living soul. 24 karat, baby. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You're going to go through things. You're going to have trials and tribulations. Hallelujah. But what he made you, amen, hallelujah, is what you're going to be. So he's going through all these different things and different people coming to him, expressing to him the pain that he in. Isn't it something how folk are coming to you and describe what you're going through? You in it. How in the world are you going to tell me what I'm in? You in the pool. Yes, I'm in the pool. You came. I was in the pool. I'll be in the pool when you leave. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Folk can perfectly break you down. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't even know their child is on drugs. Don't even know, amen, hallelujah, that drinking is going to kill them. Amen. It's going to give you cirrhosis of the liver. Hallelujah. But they can break you down, amen, to the nth degree. Hallelujah. Amen. They call that deflection in psychology. Amen. You say everything about somebody else so people won't look at you and your stuff. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So Job's friends start coming to him and telling him, amen, all kinds of things and telling him about his life and how he failed God and what you did against the will of God, because you wouldn't be going through these things if you didn't do something. Hallelujah. How about the devil just on my track trying to turn me back? Hallelujah. How about the enemy coming up to sift me as wheat? Amen. But Jesus is praying that my faith faileth not. How about if I'm just under the direct attack of the enemy? Hallelujah. Satan has me in his crosshairs and he's looking to take me out instead of praying for me. Amen. Hallelujah. Go before God and turn down your plate, get in some sackcloth and ashes, do something to help me. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Instead of condemn me in what you think I'm in and because what you think I've done, amen, to cause my, amen, the situation to be, amen, come to pass. I had nothing to do with what's going on. Hallelujah. You did something. You said something. Curse your God. His own wife said, Job, curse your God and die. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What's wrong with you? Amen. You failed God. Hallelujah. Because God don't punish you. Amen. Hallelujah. If you're not in sin. Amen. You don't go through trials and tribulation if you're not doing, amen, if you're doing the will of God. Hallelujah. Isn't something about these people so holy and so, amen, theologians in the word of God and know the will of God and know what God is doing to tell you, amen. Don't, Lord Jesus, I'm about to go, y'all. Pray for Pastor. Amen. Hallelujah. To tell you what God is saying and what God is doing and have no clue. Hallelujah. Have no clue. Have no clue.
Agape Worldwide Ministries and Pastor Renzo James Fields invite you to come worship with us in Springfield, Virginia. We're located 7240 F&G Boudinot Drive in Springfield, Virginia. Call 703-372-1174. Agape Worldwide Ministries. Real love, real people, real church.